Hello everyone, you are watching Dr. Bipin Kumar, and today is with me Rudra. He qualified first rank in 2019 in the subject of agricultural entomology. So Rudra, welcome and congratulations.
Thank you.
And please give your introduction and share your strategy how you correct.
Okay. Hi everyone, myself Rudra Gouda, and I have secured first rank in ICAR-JRF entomology for the year 2019. And I have completed my undergraduate in University of Agriculture Science, Raichur, Karnataka. And I thank Bipin Kumar sir to giving this opportunity to share my views. And first I will say about the subject and enlist the books, what are the books to read. And in entomology, we can divide the subject into three parts. That is entomology, nematology and general agriculture. In entomology, you have to read first the insecta, which is a basic book. It is published by the TNAU authors. In that insecta, there are three parts to have to concentrate more. One is morphology, that is head, thorax and abdomen, what are its appendages. We have to read, and exception insects will be there with examples. We have to notify that. And in physiology parts, means that is for systems, nervous system, reproductive system, like that all system have to be perfect. And
that will be available in the same book, insecta?
In insect only it is available. So. And in insecta, the most difficult part is taxonomy. In the taxonomy, you will get around 10 to 11 questions, and you have to be very thorough with the taxonomy. If one time you read taxonomy, you will not understand anything. You have to do so many revisions as much as possible. After completing the insecta and after thoroughing completely, you start the book, textbook of applied entomology. It is same authors of insecta, published by TNAU only. In that part, in that book, we have to concentrate some things like biological control methods, predators, parasite, with their scientific name, and history in the biological control, and which are the insects introduced to India and successful stories we have to read, and different kinds of methods like mechanical control, physical control, biological. We have to read all these methods, and in that book, you have to concentrate more on insecticide act and also on the different methods of application of the pesticides. And in that book at last, they have given an IRAC mode of classification table. In that table, there is each chemical group with their mode of action and the examples with the trade name. It is so much necessary, around 3 to 4 questions may be there on the trade names or on the mode of action. It depends upon the question paper and the year in which they concentrate more. And now, on third book is a textbook of applied entomology by D.S. Reddy. In that book, we cover all the test course. It is important there only. They have given each and every crop wise pest, their characters, their damaging symptoms with methods of management. It is enough there only. We can read for pest. And in storage entomology matters, around 8 to 10 questions we can accept in the storage entomology. It is given in that book only. You can read. And after that, in that book, there is a pesticides classification. That is, they explain each and every pesticide with their mode of action, and their how they will cause ill effects on the nature, and they have given that. You have to read that, and with the trade names and newly formulations which are recently introduced to market, there may be chance of asking like that of questions, and be thorough with the mode of action, and you know about major insecticides, like whether their contact or systemic, how they will act. It, on that part, around 2 to 3 will be there.
Question, and,
2 to 3 questions will be asked. And after reading this, most of the people will neglect about the non-insect pest, like mammalian pests and birds pests, like pigeon and other rats, like that they will ask. You be well with the scientific name of the squirrels and birds which are causing the damage to the crops, and their characteristics and how to control them. And after reading this book, you go for entomology treatise by T.V. Prasad. In that book, firstly, they have given some of the scientists which are very much important that you will not get in any books, and their contribution has been given there. You have to read that in there itself and be perfect with that. They may ask 2 to 3 in that scientist and their contribution. And in that book, they have been bullet points of topic-wise. You can read that and be perfect. And don't read about the vectors and mode of transmission in that book. It is so much difficult and it is not needed for our level. And there are some mistakes in that, so don't read that about the vector transmission. In that book at last, they have given about the different pests, whether where they lay eggs, where they go pupation, where the larva hibernates, and how the adults feed, which are the parts they feed. They have given very well explanation. Be thorough with that. And after that, they have some given some other journals like of Indian and foreign authors. Read main foreign authors and read all the Indian journals what they have given. And after the reading this book, in order to develop confidence in yourself, there is another book of the same author. It is called as Objective Entomology by T.V. Prasad. Same what you have read in topic wise, there are same topic wise question, objective questions in that book. After solving this entomology treatise by T.V. Prasad, in order to check yourself whether you have read well or not, or to develop your confidence, you can solve those book. In that objective, you can solve. And at last, they are given ARS papers and JRF papers are there that you can solve later. And after reading this book, you go for refresher entomology by C.P. Vijji. And in that refresher entomology, it is very important that in that you get some points which will not read those points in any other books. And in that books, you neglect about the taxonomy part because it is outdated taxonomy is given in that. You don't read that. And you read for taxonomy, only insecta is more than enough. You be perfect with the insecta. And after reading this, so many will ask whether the questions will come in the economic part. Yes, really the questions will come in the economic part. In economic part like apiculture, sericulture and lab culture, there will be more questions. Around 10 to 20 may come and those decide the ranks. In that, for that you read the element of economic entomology by Vasantraj David. The book is there. It is also from TNAU author only. You read that book, it is very nice. And if you have any doubts in pest course, you refer for TNAU website or NBIR website. There will be character of each insect and what are the modification and how they cause the damage. They are explained well in TNAU website. You read that. And this is enough for entomology. And all of them will read entomology and many of them will neglect nematology. Where you will get around 30 questions. But last year they got 30 questions. This year we got around 10 questions in nematology.
Only 10 questions this year from nematology?
Approximately 10 we got. Okay. In nematology, there is one book that is Introductory of Plant Nematology. It has ICAR publication only by Bajaj and Walia. It is so much important book that if you read one time, you can't understand anything. First, you have to read 2 to 3 times and understand the book. In that you eliminate taxonomy part, it is very difficult, you can't understand in that book. And you just to be thorough about the history of the nematology, where they cause outbreak and how they devastated the world and their history. And later in that book, they have extraction methods of nematodes, in that one or two questions may come. And at last, they have given about brief about each nematode, their character and about how they cause damage and which are the examples of them in the history. You read that all, and at last of the nematode, in that book there is some list of some different diseases caused by different nematodes. You be perfect with that. And in journals also of nematology has been enlisted in that book at last. You read that also. And for nematology, for taxonomy part, you read Plant Nematology by Upadhyay and Divedi book. It is there. In that you read nematology, and in that also cover integrated nematology management. It is given well in that book, and different other methods in nematology like cultural, mechanical, physical is well explained in that book. You read that book, it is more enough. And recently one book is published, while we are reading it was not there, now it is came, the nematology refresher. It is published by ARS seniors only, it is good. First, who don't understand that Bajaj and Walia, go for refresher book. It is simple, in language it is there, you can understand. After you have gained grip in that subject, you can go for solving the Bajaj and Walia, you can read at later. And now the third part is general agriculture, where almost all the ranks decide in general agriculture, that most of the peoples will neglect. That is, they think to read general agriculture at last after completing.
How many questions this year come from?
Around 30.
30 questions, that is rank deciding.
Most of will neglect that part. If they thought to read that after, if they permit the time is there after entomology and nematology, they will go for general agriculture.
But what is your suggestion?
But according to me, while reading daily, you spend at least 2 to 3 hours for general agriculture. Don't neglect it, where the rank actually decides. For general agriculture, you read Nemrasun, the book. Your bulletin points are there for subject wise. It is very much important. You read that. And again, for entomology student, in which area we have to concentrate in general agriculture, means we have to concentrate in statistics, extension and pathology, Mendelian genetics, and in soil science, that different chemicals, their ratios, NPK, how much it will be, their fertilizers, we have to read that all, it is important. And at the NEMRAS, at starting, they have given full form of different institutions and where they are located and which are the history happened till from pre-independence to till now, we have to read that. And after reading general agriculture, now there you have to concentrate also on recent current affairs, like which are the central government schemes in agriculture and which are the new innovations in the field of agriculture and which are the new varieties developed and what is the food production strategy, which state leads in which crop. You have to study all that, it is important. And now I am going to share about the strategies and view that what I have followed for my preparation of the exam. I have started for reading from the 7th sem itself.
7th semester means
in Rave. In Rave.
From 4th year.
From 4th year. In Rave I have started for preparation. I have just simply was reading in the Rave. But when 8th sem started, I took it serious and I took completely dedicated for 6 months and studied fully and without wasting the time. In entomology, first when you start the reading the book, first only you don't try to read all the things, you can't understand. First 2 to 3 times you read the book and know the outline of the book and which are the topics have been covered. Just you know the skeleton of the book and then you go solving each and every topic. And when you become full perfect in that subject, then you have to go for objective solving. First only you don't go for solving objective. You will be panicked because some questions will be more tough. What you will do, you will search answer from top to bottom. From when you solving the question paper, if you not get any answer, then you will go to original books to see. Please don't do that. First, be well thorough with basics and you must able to answer that. If any angle, if they ask a question in basic, you must be able to answer the questions. In entomology, there are no shortcuts. You have to read continuously. You have to keep in touch with the subject. And only key to success in entomology is revision, revision, revision. Mm-hmm. Only you have to revision. There, because scientific names will be forgotten. Almost we will forget that new terminologies. Yes. We have to keep in contact with daily, we have to read the subject. Well, coming to objectives, you read objectives when you have completed all the theory books what I have said and you have well gripped in subject, then you go for solving objectives. Then when there is still 2 months for exam, you start for doing objectives. And after completion of objectives, at last 1 month, you don't solve any objectives, just go on repeating the basic books. What I have seen, because most of the questions will be settled from the basics only. They will not refer objective questions, but only objective questions are to gain build up our confidence in your for your cross verification those objective books. But you read only for basic books, continuous revision at last 1 month. Don't read any objective books. And now I am going to say some of the objective books. And for entomology, there is Shravan M. Haldar book is their objective entomology. So in that book, there are some difficult questions also is there. While solving, you ignore those questions. To solve which are you able to solve and you know which question may come. You solve like the tough questions and leave full difficult questions. And next, Vinayak question is their objective entomology. It is very good. You solve all the questions in that. And after, I have said already TV Prasad objective is there. Na? You solve that also. And in these objective books, there is some problem that the questions, some answers are wrong. When you are solving, you search for the correct answer and cross-verify with your friends who are reading in entomology or ask any of your seniors the doubts, which they only know the answer. At your level, you can't know that. So, your seniors may help you in correcting that. And next, from nematology, there is only one book for objective from Manjunath, Nematology Objective by author Manjunath. You read that, it is enough. When you come for general agriculture, there is Objective General Agriculture by S.R. Kantwa. Mm-hmm. It is a very much important book. In that, they have given subject-wise objective book questions, around 300 questions for each subject. You will be perfect with that. In that book, you don't read veterinary science, dairy science, and fisheries and economics. Mm-hmm. But you don't read. You stress more on stats and extension and pathology, agronomy. Soil science is better. You have to concentrate more. More questions will become. And after solving this, in that SR Kantwa, at middle there are 100 pages about the recent trends in agriculture. They have been given well there. Read that. And after time permits, some question papers are there of each JRF of every subject. If you need to solve, you can solve that if your time is there. And now I am going to say about the exam, how it will be. And the exam is on the online mode from our batch. Then it is one thing, if you see online, it is good when compared to offline, because you will spend more time in bubbling, and if you once you answered in offline, it gone, you can't change any other answer.
But here is the option, you can change
at any time, how many times you can answer the question.
Okay, okay.
You can change, and there are only 160 questions.
What about the matching?
Match the following was there, and now this year fully
totally
MCQ. In that 160 questions, 100 questions will be easy. That whoever prepared for subject entomology attending the exam, they can solve easily 100. Those 100 questions not decide the rank at all. In that remaining 60, in that 30 questions are somewhat twisting questions, and if you well thorough with the basic concepts, you can understand. They ask indirect type of questions in 30, you can answer that. And in remaining 30, it will be tough, and where the rank decides, and you have to put more effort in those type of questions.
So this year, how many questions you attempted?
153 questions.
153 out of
160.
So how what was your marks?
537 marks.
537 marks. Okay, because this question is very frequent. Student used to ask what was the
537 marks.
537
marks. For each question, there will be 4 marks for correct answer. For incorrect, the 1 marks will be deducted. And when you are going for an exam, don't be panicked first. You be relaxed. You are being thinking, all will be in tension that we will get seat or not, whether paper will be easier or not. You leave that is secondary. First you be cool and relax and start attending the question paper. First you start attending the paper which are very easy for you, and without thinking you can answer, you attend those. First only you don't spend on time which are tough or which are tricky. You will spend most of the time there only. So first you attend just which are you know you. That you complete 160 first questions, and come for second time. In that some will be tricky, and you have to think that. You be relaxed, you will get answer if you think that. There will be answer will be there only, they will not much be tough. You can answer those type of questions. And remaining 30 questions will be really tough, and that if the question is tough for you, it will be tough for all. Don't be panicked that your level of reading, all will be same level of reading and preparation. If it is tough, you leave it full. If you not heard anywhere, you don't attempt it at all, you leave it. And if any still there is some doubts, like your answer will be in 2 options or 3 options, you have to take some amount of risk in order to secure rank. You have to take some calculated risk. I will say that in 30 questions, if you answer around 10 to 20 questions, if 20 questions are right, 80 marks will be get, and minus 10 if you go on, means 70 marks will get, and you will be stand separate from the crowd. And you will be one step forward than the others. And in that time, you have to take some risk. In order to get JRF rank, you must minimally attend around 145 plus or 150 plus.
145 above.
150, sir.
Yeah.
Benchmark, we have to attend 150 in order to deserve rank within 10.
Okay.
150. In that, however we attend, we will lose 10 questions. Without our knowing, 10 questions will be gone. They will be wrong.
Yes.
So it's safer said to attend more than 150.
150.
I would say some things like after finishing all your preparations, if still time is remaining, go for original author books like Daliwal and Arora book, Daliwal and Srivastava. So like that, you know the concept which is you know the things that others might not know the things, that your rank will be different. JRF rank will be known only from the things that other people should not know the things. You have to read like that of things. In that, you have to read like that book. So when you have time remaining after these basic books, and hope this we
are... Yes, first of all, they have to cover the basic, then only they have to go for
some
tough,
original author
original books. Author.
These are like guide-like books. And
okay.
Ready-made books, but original authors is somewhat difficult.
Somewhat difficult. Okay.
You have to read that books in order to get rank or anything.
Okay.
And I hope this video is helpful for my juniors who are preparing for exams.
Definitely, this will be helpful.
And I will wish all my juniors to prepare well and do well in your exams. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Rudra, for giving me such valuable time as well as the input.
Yes.
Bye-bye. All the best.